Hello everyone and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel. So for today's video guys, I'm gonna show you 6G on a 2.5 inch get extra strong urea test. It's a urea grade. It's for urea units in fertilizer plants. This is pretty common units in fertilizer plants. Specifically for fertilizer plants, that's where you're gonna find lots of urea grade materials. So I'm gonna show you from beginning to the end. I'm gonna do 3-cap pass on the end, and here we go from the scratch. So we got a little two pieces, 2.5 inch, and we're gonna do prep. With prep, we're gonna start cleaning in and out. Here you can see it's a 2.5 inch extra strong. With over half inch thickness. So really important with this material is to clean in and out. Everything gotta be nice and shiny. Go always a couple inches from the top edge and even from the inside, as when you're running hot, as you progress in welding, all that impurity can just go inside your weld and just be harder to control your puddle. So here for the gap, I'm gonna go with 2.5 up to 4 mil max, as I'm gonna use a 332 rod. As long as you can wiggle 332 inside, that should be good enough. That's it. This is a TIG rod, 25-22-2. That's a urea grade. It's a modified 316 with extra low silicon and higher content of molybdenum. That's specifically, that's why they call it urea-grade. That's a modified 316. So where, if you welded before with the 316, 308, there's a little variance. Pretty much the basic is the same. You have to purge, you have to do everything as you would do with any other stainless. It's just a little bit different behavior of that rod, of the material, as I'm going to show you later in the video. A couple things that you have to pay attention to. So we're going to close it. We're going to insert perch hose inside. We're going to use a diffuser on my hose. Aluminum tape, couple holes on front to vent out all the oxygen inside. That's it, pretty much same basic setup as for any other stainless. So on the flow meter, I'm gonna go up to 30 liters per minute, as I like to run hot, so that higher pressure of purge helps me to keep my root nice and uniform, to prevent any grapes. Pretty much basically almost like pushing your puddle outside. That's the kind of pressure I like. So I'm gonna run 95 amps here. You can go lower. I'm gonna walk the cup on my root and doing back feed technique. Okay, once you start preheat, try add a rod right away. Don't pause too much, as you want to prevent any internal undercuts. As I said, really important with this one, keep that rod constantly connected, as a little bit strange behavior, just a reaction with the environment. As soon as you pull that rod out, just oxidize on the surface of your weld puddle, creates like a sugaring. It's just like a fast freezes, and then just gives you a little bit more trouble to reconnect again, and harder to establish that nice and smooth puddle. So I'm gonna go on the bottom both sides up to those two tacks on 3 and 9 o'clock, and this is where I'm gonna stop. Okay, that's the root, nice and shiny, purge is good. I like that little bit beefier root inside, as later on is gonna prevent actually just gonna give me worry, no worries about sag back on my hot pass, as I like to run 120, 130 on my hot pass. So I removed those two tacks. I'm gonna leave that one on 12 o'clock. I'm gonna put a foil again and purchase again a couple minutes to get rid of all that oxygen we insert, especially with the grinding. It's a good habit with a bigger diameter pipes to weld in between tacks and leave cutout tacks for the last stage. And then you only got one time use with the grinder, get rid of all those tacks. Okay, now I'm just gonna continue on up to the top. Still using a kind of back feed technique. I'm feeding from the top part. Try to keep it constantly connected inside the puddle. Just side to side motion, stretch that puddle. Now the top part. I'm doing the dipping technique side to side. I'm just gonna reposition here. I don't wanna stop. As I'm gonna show you later, it just creates that weird looking appearance on my weld puddle. As you can see here, it's like a sugaring from the outside. It's gonna be later on my fill passes. You're gonna see it more clearly. And for the root, root is good. Root is good. No worries. It's good. It's shiny. It's healthy. And I'm just gonna get rid of that tack on the top and continue on welding with the root. Okay, the root pass is done. Root pass is done. Now for the hot pass, I'm gonna run 120, 332. I'm gonna use the same rod for the hot pass. It doesn't really matter. You can do 1/8 as well, especially if you got a little bit of beefier root, so you're not you don't have to worry about the sag back. Usually I know lots of guys are worried about the sag back, especially if they low profile inside with their root. So yeah, if you hot and 332 and 1/8, it might do sag back a little bit on your root. But as I said, one of the reasons why I like beefier root, so I'm not worried about the sag back at all. Okay, and for the hot pass, nothing fancy, same thing. Stretch that puddle. It's a little bit better for your hot pass and for other fill passes to keep that rod inside. It's nice and smooth, it goes good, except when you stop, and I'm gonna show you later. It just creates that little crater outside on a surface. It just looks like a sugaring. As I said, this is upgraded 316 urea grade, 25-22-2, extra low silicon and higher molybdenum content. Like any other, as I mentioned, like you're familiar with 316, 308, all those materials, they're all pretty much similar. Just have to learn which material works better, which way, what is good tips to have. So for the fill passes, I start on the top. There's no any particular reason, just we can start on the bottom. So the interpass is at 300 Fahrenheit, so we gotta be careful with that. There's a QC around, he likes to poke his hand around and check with the temp gun to make sure that I'm following welding procedure. They're doing a X-ray, so there's a no bend test. It's X-ray, PMI, and FT ferrite test. They want to check ferrite test for a hot cracking. That's why you have to go 300 interpass, max 300. But I like to crank a little bit higher when he's not around, and always double check. So I don't wanna. I'm not trying to make a career out of this test coupon. I want to finish it as soon as possible. Now it's pretty much. This is the example I was telling you before. This is what happened. It looks like sugaring. It looks like that crater outside that's created, so you have to grind that out. You can start on that. If you do, it'll just give you a hard time. It's not gonna melt properly, and it's lots of impurities inside. It's hard to control, hard to start. So grind it out. I'm sure that's one of the reasons why it's like that. It's the torch I'm using. If I got the control on my torch, stop, start, pause, post flow, I think might prevent that. Or even if you got a good helper welder, so you can go zero on your remote every time you want to stop. But that's not in my case. I don't have any welder helper available like that, which is good. I'm just kidding. Okay, so pretty much filter flash, two more passes, and it should be filter flash, and it's gonna be ready for capping. I'm not sure did I mention it's 1/8 size of my tungsten. It's 2% aerated, cup size 8. So for the root pass on this one, as I said, go 95. You can even go lower. Hot pass I did 120, and all those field passes up to here I'm running 150 amps. And that's it. Filter flash. I grinded stop starts here. Stops. And gonna buffing wheel. Clean your passes. I forget to clean a couple times here, but it's not a big deal. It just makes your life easier, makes your puddle more clear and easier to control. And if your QC is around, that's why buffing wheel works good. So you get rid of all those heat coloring indication on your coupon. The good thing about this kind of material, same as the stainless, cools off really fast, faster than carbon. And in this stage, you can even insert air hose inside your coupon and just let that air running. It cools off and keeps that temperature that is required by welding procedure. As you can see here, there's flying creatures around. That's the beauty of the summertime. As soon as you strike an arc, they just fly right in a puddle, just like kamikazes. And they taste bad, tell you that. Okay, so for the first pass, you see I go on a couple mils here on the first edge. I don't do any wide beads. I don't stretch that much. I'm just gonna go with the three passes on my cap. You can do two as well, but you know, just be a little bit wider. I think three passes should be nice and proper for this thickness, for this type. So I'm gonna place a second pass here. It's gonna be cover overlap 50% of my first pass. Okay, this is the second pass. Just overlapping 50% on my first pass. First and last pass are most important, guys. First pass, you want to have that straight edge. straight edge that covers on the pipe side. You want to have it nice and straight if you want your weld looks really nice. Like any other weld, you know, that's our weld is professional deformation. We like to go around and check other people's welds and judge. You can tell by the weld someone's you know, control and concentration, especially when you're welding. There's multitasking always involved, you know, hand-eye coordination. You can tell he's a good welder, he got a good control. I like to do that, but as soon as you got one misstep, as I got here, you know, all that 90% of a nice cap you did, they'll say, ah, look at that, that's not good. But that's what happened. That's we're just humans, we make mistakes. That's the difference. They use robots nice days, especially on orbital welds, furnaces and all those tubes, but still they need the hand welder to do root pass. And I hope it's gonna stay like that for a long, long time. Okay, and the last one, the third pass, that's the cherry on the top. In any other welding, you really gotta focus here, you gotta pay attention to details. Keeping a nice same vid of your weld bead, straight edge, maintain the same the same step on the both sides. A little tip, I got a couple comments before, they asked me, do they want to lower down the temp on a cap? It all depends. I think the most important thing is just for material to be cooled. If it's too hot, and then your puddle is just gonna be a little bit like out of control, it's gonna be too hot, you can lower the temp and you can wait for your piece to cool down a little bit. Okay, that's it guys. That's it pretty much for this video. This is 3-pass cap Urea grade. I hope you learned something. Hope I gave you some useful tips to do it if you down on the road, if you ever come up on welding something like this, urea. That's it. Okay guys, you gotta burn to learn, and hope you guys like it, enjoy it, subscribe, like, and see you in the next one guys. Take care and play safe.